Hello, my name is Thomas Kim, and I recently began to teach myself Direct2D 3D, three-dimensional graphics by myself. And then I realized that without understanding fundamentals about the computer graphics, I thought it would be really hard to understand. So I don't know about Direct2D as well, but I read some MSDN documentations and tried, and I found some very good tips to help you understand Direct2D and two-dimensional computer graphics. And then after learning two-dimensional graphics, we will also learn Direct2D three-dimensional computer graphics. The objective of this, I also decided to make a series of videos to learn speaking English and writing English to improve my English actually. And also I want to record my videos for my children, my sons and my daughters who are in high school right now, but they will, after graduating their high school, they probably want to learn computer graphics. So this, if I record this tutorial, the courses that I teach myself, two-dimensional computer graphics, it will be very, very beneficial to them. So whoever are interested to learn Direct2D computer graphics along with graphics, you can follow with me and you can also benefit my teachings. And also I want to I would like to make friends with any people from any corner of the world. I'm not racist and I'm native South Korean. However, as long as you want to make friends with me and also want to help me to improve my English, I welcome anyone. And to prerequisites to understand my videos, you may have to understand some basic C and C++ language. I will not teach C or C++ language, but I will teach some algebra or geometry of vector, mathematical vector, I mean. I will explain, you might already know about this stuff, but I will guide you how to apply your knowledge to two-dimensional and three-dimensional computer graphics. To follow with me, you need some hardware and software requirements. Windows 7 or above, you should have. And Visual Studio 2010 or above should be already installed. In my case, I'm using Windows 8.1, and I'm using Visual Studio 2013 version right now. Okay, let's go. Say, from file menu in Visual Studio, click new project, new files, then select MFC application. It will be our first lesson for Direct2D and MFC application. So the solution name will be MFC with Direct2D. And the application name will be just MFC with, I will make just simple MFC D2D. I will just make simple like this, then start. I will use multiple view. I will use, for the first time, we will use a single document. Then I will just finish click. Okay, in a moment later, the project in the solution view, the project is MFC 2D. D2D is created. I will compile it and run it by Ctrl F5. Ctrl F5 is build and run without debugging. You can access already, or always access like debug. Yeah, Control F5, start without debugging. Okay, the application is built like this, and we see nothing here yet, but I will guide you how to enable Direct2D in your MFC application. Okay, so in the class view, select and view. You have to class view class. If you click it, view class in the class view menu, scroll. You can find this is constructor. View class constructor. So you in here you have to enable this. Enable D2D support. Since my machine is pretty slow, I cannot see. Okay. Enable D2D Direct2D. Okay. So next thing you need to do is to add a message handler. Right click here in the class view and D2D view class again, right click. Then select class wizard and the message tab. Add a custom message here. AFX in the message draw 2D. And you have to select the registered message, and the handler name will be draw2d. Okay, click OK. Then edit code. Here, we are going to flash out. Here, let's see. Chwind render target p. Render target. You can get a render target instance like this. LPARAM. As you can see, LPARAM is coming from as an argument of this method. Then let's clear render target. Set matrix, set transformation D2D1F, D2D1 matrix, then identity. P render target clears display D2D one color app open D2D1 color app then color white. Then we will draw a box. See client lab. Actually, we can do this. D2D, D2D1. CD2D, D1 size. Size F, right. Size P render target just size. Okay. Here CD2D1 D rectangle F. Shift zero up left corner, left top corner, left, then size, width, minus, up, size, height, minus, back up. Okay, we got now rectangle. Then we will draw P when the target, draw rectangle. We need a brush, so okay, we can create a brush on the fly. CD2D, solid color brush, solid color brush. We need render target, P, render target, and color, D2D1, color up, D2D1, color up, black. Okay. This creates brush, then rectangle. Okay. We need point. Okay. Let's go. Okay. Okay, it's working. Like this. I will fix the size a little bit bigger. Okay, this is our first MFC and Direct2D graphics. It's simple, isn't it? Thank you. Bye.